Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, and today we're gonna talk about bags I love but I won't buy. So I was watching Ron from Ramirofy, I think is how you pronounce it. Ron, correct me if I am wrong. But I was watching his video, and I'm not sure if he's created this tag. I've seen different iterations of it on the internet, but it was a list of bags that he loves, but he's not gonna buy. Okay, and so I thought to myself, you know what? I'm gonna make that tag too. So I listed a couple of bags that I have been eyeing for a while, but have not taken the plunge and likely will not be taking the plunge. Okay, I'll start with the Mini Lady Dior in any form, whether it is the fabric with embroidery, I think it's called the D-Light, or whether it's the actual Mini Lady Dior, which is the leather one. And I think the print is called Canage. So I'm not going to be buying that bag because, specifically for the Mini Lady Dior, it is a very classic looking bag. It is, after all, named after Lady Diana, who was the person who made it famous. I think it was even created for her. To me, it's a very classy design. It's a very structured design, which is not something that I find myself drawn to. I don't know if you can tell by my collection, a lot of my bags are slouchy, unstructured. If there are any that are structured, they're not meant to last in that structure. I was initially attracted to the D-Light versions of the Lady Dior, but I also recognize that fabric like that, and I'll get into that a little bit more later in the video, is not something that would be useful for me, knowing how clumsy I can get. Dior also, for that matter, do not hold its value. Like, if you go into the secondhand market, you'll find a good number of this Lady Dior's in the market. Next, this is a rather controversial one. It's the Chanel Classic Flap in any, well, no, not in any size. I am interested in the Mini Classic Flap, but the small, medium, and maxi and jumbo, no. Anything that has that second flap, I really don't appreciate. I understand the purpose of that flap is to keep the structure off the bag. However, it's just not for me. I have had the opportunity to own one where one of my friends who needed quick cash sold hers to me, but I also had the opportunity to sell it back to her, which I did, because it just really wasn't a bag for me. It, like, right now, especially now with the game that Chanel is playing, like, there's a certain quota. You can only buy two of the classic bags every year, and they keep increasing their prices 4 times a year. It's just become ridiculous. And now I hear they're planning on putting up stores that are just for their VIPs. So I think I've been outpriced by Chanel at this point, even at the secondhand market. And to be honest, even when I wasn't, I really was not a fan of the classic flap. I found that the Mona Lisa pocket at the back was pretty much useless. The love letter pocket, again, pretty much useless. And the lipstick holder in the middle, it just was odd to me. The design of that bag was perfect for the time when Coco Chanel first came out with it. But in this day and age, I don't think it is a functional design anymore. The next thing, actually there's two things, and for very similar reasons. It is the Louis Vuitton Capucine and the Fendi Peekaboo. Okay. And if you look at these two bags, their structures are very similar, wherein they are rather boxy structures with a divider in the middle and a top handle. And if I'm not mistaken, in both cases, the top handles are not removable. And in both cases as well, you can attach a longer shelf for you to be able to carry it crossbody. Okay. It's just not a design that works for me. I don't like bags that have partitions in the middle because I find that it limits what you can put inside the bag. Don't get me wrong, I like the look of them. I like the peekaboo. I've been looking at the capucines for a while now. But yeah, one of the reasons why I've never, and I don't think I will ever, buy these two bags is because of that reason. None of my bags, as far as I'm concerned, have any partitions in the middle. With the exception of this Coach, I think they call it the lunchbox. So you can see here, it's double zipped. So there is a divider in the middle for the two compartments. And I'll have to be honest with you, the reason why I don't use this bag is, it's just got some stuffing. The reason I don't use this bag is precisely because of that reason. Like, I would probably use this so much more if it wasn't partitioned into two compartments, if it was just one large compartment there, because that means that I would be able to put in everything that I need to bring with me, and it would have the same capacity as my puzzle bag. Okay, now the next two are actually categories of bags that I would not buy into, and I've touched upon this when I spoke about the D-Lite. Okay, so that's I'm looking at luxury totes that are made of wicker or fabric, right? So I'm thinking Dior book tote, fabric, embroidered, the Chanel Deauville fabric with chain and leather handles, the YSL Rive Gauche. I just don't think the material that's used merits the price point of these bags. And also, I've come to the, not just the realization, but the acceptance that I am not a tote girl. I never have been. Even back in my uni days, I had always been somebody who took a backpack with me if I needed to bring a lot of things. The closest that I have to a tote right now is this is my YSL bucket bag, which is large enough to carry my laptop. I have a organizer inside that helps me find stuff, because otherwise it's just a big black hole. But this is the closest to a tote that I own. I know myself that I have a tendency, when I have a big bag like this, I like to fill it. And I don't like empty spaces, so if I fill this up, it's going to be quite heavy. And for it to be balancing on one shoulder or the other, it's just not the most comfortable for me, so I always go with a backpack if I have to bring a lot of things. And if I was even thinking about getting a tote, I would probably go with a Longchamp, and the ones that you can actually fold and put in your travel bag. Because the truth of the matter is, I'm only probably ever going to bring a tote with me for travel. That's it. Okay, and then on the opposite side of the spectrum, the next category that I'm not buying into, even though I love the look of them, are micro bags. Or as Cassie $2 sign says, tiny bag energy, right? I see a lot of this. Like, I know Fendi has got these little bags that are almost the size of bag charms and can actually be used as bag charms. I know Chanel's come out with a couple of them. Coach has got a few of them as well. It's not very practical, and the price point, like especially for the luxury brands, you can buy a full size bag. Several of them if you were going to spend that money anyway. So like the practical, logical side of me is telling me, no, don't do it. But whenever I see one, I'm like, oh, they're so cute. Tiny bag energy that only fits like a card, or not even, sometimes not even a card. I know like when Jacquemus came out with their one, you can't even fit cards in there. And yeah, if it's just the size of a bag charm, it's just really not something that I'm gonna put my money on now. Right, so those are the bags that I love looking at. They're just so gorgeous. And if money was not an object, if it was not any factor in my decision making, I probably will. But also how my brain works when I see so many things that are not being used, I just know it's just gonna sit somewhere as a decoration rather than a functional item. So there you go. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comment section down below, or if you make your own video, what sort of bags do you love but you won't buy? Anybody who would like to do this tag, please go ahead. Thank you very much for watching. If you don't mind, please like, subscribe if you haven't already. Bye.